What personal impact did Knowing Mother have on you?
Well, I would say that I came up with the blessing of having a very rich and deeply spiritual family. My parents, my mother was a daily churchgoer. We grew up right across the street from a church. She was a CCD teacher for 50 years. And I grew up in a very deeply spiritual household. And also living across the street from Capuchin Franciscan friars, having them as my first sort of role models was fantastic. And I often thank God for that opportunity that we grew up in such a beautiful environment. But I would say Mother Teresa, knowing her, just strengthened my faith. Certainly we witnessed miracles around her and saw extraordinary things. She was an incredibly deeply loving individual. She was completely selfless. I'd never met anybody in my life like that who could totally empty herself in complete service to the poorest of the poor. So I think some of my favorite memories of her, Annie, were probably being able to pray next to her. I remember walking into the theater and to the theater, actually, to one of the Missionaries of Charity homes. And as soon as we walked into the chapel, she recognized me coming in and wanted me to kneel next to her. And being able to pray next to her and to share the same prayer book, hear her very deep speaking voice and her very high, beautiful singing voice, was really, those are times that will live forever with me. She was such a mother to all of us and certainly to our family. I have pictures of her feeding my oldest son the bottle. And, you know, she was just so thoughtful and loving on so many levels. And I think that we all learned that the value and the purpose of our lives is really to love and to be loved, and that we must share that joy of loving with each person that we come into contact with. So I think it was selfless service, loving each person that you come into contact, trying to see the face of God in each person that you encounter. Never allow anybody who comes to you to go away better and happier with your smile, your eyes, your face. In fact, she would oftentimes challenge me to smile at somebody I didn't want to smile at 8 times a day. And I'm still trying to do that. It's not easy. But she felt that a smile was the start of great sanctity. And it's not insignificant, because once you give it away, it becomes infinite. So that was the beauty of Mother Teresa. It was always in the small things with great love that were holding the most importance for her. When I was in Calcutta with her, with my wife, I remember looking for Mother in the house one afternoon, because I was wanting to know what house she wanted me to visit the next morning. And I went up through the second floor to try to find her. She wasn't in the chapel, she wasn't in the office. And I went around the corner and I saw her on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor, just like one of the other sisters. There wasn't anything too small for her to do herself. And she said, I remember asking her one time what she would have done had she not, you know, follow this work, this beautiful work of the Missionaries of Charity. And she laughed and she said, well, I'm very good at scrubbing toilets. You know, there wasn't anything too small or insignificant for her to find value in, because she was doing everything for Jesus.